Hey, what's up guys, this is Akshay from AS Learning, and today in this video we'll be seeing object detection and custom image annotation using a tool named opensense.ai. So a huge shout out to these guys. They have made a very brilliant tool, and whenever you want to build any custom object detection model, annotation is very important and this tool can come very handy. So let's, for example purpose, I'll be picking any Harley Davidson bike. Let's take these two images, okay? And what I have to do is I have to create labels. Right now what my objective is, that whenever any image of a bike would come as the input to my model, so my model should tell, okay fine, in this image this is the wheel, this is the engine, this is the seat, okay? Now to make my model understand that, okay, in an image this is what a wheel looks like, this is what a seat looks like, I need to have training data set for a model on which, by seeing that data, my model will learn from it, okay? And here with these two examples we'll be seeing how to create that data set, and also they have an inbuilt object detector. And we'll be also seeing how that can be leveraged. Okay. So the most basic way is, first of all, we need to add labels, right? Now, let's assume our objective is to identify tires, engine, seats. Okay. Let's keep it simple. Only four things. So let's first go to edit labels. Okay. So the first label which I'll be adding will be tires. Or let's keep it singular, tire. Okay. Now we need to add one more. So one more will go with, let's go for headlights. Then go for engine and tires, engine, and let's go for seat. Okay. Good. Now what I have to do is, I can do one thing is, I can manually annotate it. Okay, so here you can use a rectangular annotation, a point, line and polygon. Okay, so let's first see how rectangle works. So simple, I've selected the let's make it better, let's go like this. Okay, and let's add the label tire. We have one more here. This one is not proper, let's make it a bigger bit. Yeah, again tire. Then we have the engine, let's go with the engine. Finally we have the seat. Okay, now here in this rectangular annotation you must be seeing that we are not able to capture the entire thing. Okay, and we are also getting some other parts being occupied, like here in this case I have to get the headlight into the frame to capture the entire tire, right? So there are different ways in which you can do annotation and solve this issue. Okay, so one of the ways, go with just point annotation, just do a click, okay, and go with engine. Okay, such kind of annotation is important, is useful when you have small things. Okay, in case of engine you want a bigger thing to cover, so point won't come handy. When you have small things, like any screw or any nut bolt, okay, such kind of a thing, so in such cases point annotation comes in handy. Then we also have line annotation, where if you have very slim things, like for example this rod, so this can be covered into a line annotation. And last but not least, we have polygon. Polygon is very nice, I can say. See how I can very nicely leverage all the points and cover only the necessary things. So this can be a tire for me. Okay, so these are the four types of annotation which are provided to us by namesense.ai. then apart from this, If you want to leverage their inbuilt model for doing object detection automatically, you can also do that. So all you need to do is just go in actions and do a load AI model. They have given two models. One is Coco SSD object detection using rectangles, and the second one is PoseNet. So PoseNet is helpful when you have humanly images, when you are doing dancing, exercising, and you wanna capture the poses. So at that time, PoseNet is nice. And when you have things like bike or such kind of things, when at that time Coco SSD is better. So let's see how Coco SSD gives its output on this image. Let's see what it detects. Yeah, so Coco SSD has only one class in it, and that is motor class, a motorcycle. So this entire outward frame is automatically coming from Coco SSD, and this is the exact model or the way in which image detection on makesense.ai works. Okay, they leverage such kind of models and they tell you what kind of an image it is. Okay, so we have seen manual annotation, we have seen the four types of it: line, point, polygon. We also saw object detection, how we can use Coco SSD or PoseNet to automatically detect the different objects or the entire image. And now the last thing which remains is exporting the results. Okay, we saw importing. Now if you want to export results, all you need to do is just go on actions and do export annotations. So they give three formats in which you can export the annotation. Okay, the first one is YOLO format, the second one is XML, and the third one is CSV. Yeah, they also have another format of JSON, which is available when you do polygon type of annotation. Okay, so I have tried the four formats and I'll show you how it appears. So this is the CSV annotation format. Yeah, so here you can see that I have my image name, my element to be detected, its coordinates, and the resolution of the image. Okay, then another one which I tried was of XML. So this is the output of I'm not sure whether it's the output of XML or YOLO, because it is a one and the same way only. They are just giving a text file, and in the text file you have these coordinates. Okay, then and there's one more in which you get an XML file. Okay, yeah, so this is how the XML works, and I think so these texts are coming from the YOLO. Okay, so my bad. Yeah, so sorry, it was entirely my bad. So when you use YOLO, you get the output in the form of these text files. Yeah, in text files, and when you do XML annotation, you get such kind of output. Okay, so we saw a mini couple of things. We saw manual annotation, we saw object detection, we saw different types of formats in which you can do it, and also how to export it. Okay, so if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, do check other AI videos on AS learning, and stay tuned to AS for more such amazing tech stuff. Take care, peace out.